Allie, if you've never had a migraine headache, be very thankful. They're more than just a supersized headache. They can send you to bed for hours, even days. And a major trigger for migraines is stress. If you've looked at the calendar, you know that this is a major time of stress for a lot of people. Dr. Van Susteren talked about that a little while ago. A lot of people are trying to meet their holiday obligations, and that's why this morning we're talking with Dr. Gary Kaplan. He's founder and medical director of the Kaplan Center for Integrative Medicine and also an expert on migraines and how to avoid them. I guess that's more important, how to avoid them. Good morning.
Good morning, and the real trick is avoiding migraines.
Well, first of all, before we get to that, we said that they're different than just your basic old supersized headache.
Right.
What's the difference between just a really bad headache and a migraine?
Well, there can be a little bit of a blurring of the borders, but the fact is migraines are sick headaches. With migraines, you typically have some nausea associated with them, you may have vomiting, and you have real sensitivity to light and to sound, and they may put you to bed for a couple of days. So migraines can last anywhere from 4 to 4 hours until about 72 hours, three days. There's a throbbing quality to the headache, and they come in kind of two broad categories. They come in the classical form, which has aura associated with it, and aura gives you some visual distortions, or you may find that you're clumsy for about 10, 15 minutes before the onset of the headache. And then the common migraine, which is what the overwhelming majority of people have, which doesn't have an aura associated with it, but it's a throbbing, nauseated, sick headache. And typically people want to withdraw. They want to go into a bedroom where it's dark and it's quiet. Sleep can actually help resolve the headache.
Okay.
But it can incapacitate you for up to several days at a time.
Knock on wood, I'm one of those people that rarely gets a headache, but are there certain people who may be more prone to migraine headaches than others?
Yeah, women overall are more prone. About three times as many women get migraines as men. Overall, we see about 30 million people in the country suffer from migraines. And of that, about 5 to 10% of children and adolescents can also suffer migraines. So it's a headache, it's a condition which affects the young as well as adults.
Okay, so let's talk about what triggers them.
Well, there's a lot of environmental triggers. So stress is certainly a very big trigger in it. And what do we mean by stress? You know, this holiday season, the fact of the matter is we've only got 24 hours in a day.
Right.
That's it. And so you have to be intelligent about what you do with that 24 hours. Prioritize what you're going to do. It's okay to say no to some things and not attend some events. You need to guard your sleep. Sleep is critical. In fact, if you start disrupting your sleep, getting too little or even too much sleep, or you start shifting the hours that you sleep, so normally you go to bed at 10, now you start going to bed at 1 o'clock because you're up wrapping all those gifts, that in and of itself can be a trigger for a migraine. So making sure that your sleep remains consistent and that you're getting adequate amount of sleep for yourself, which is typically about 7 to 8 hours a night.
Okay, somebody might take, let's say, pain medicine to either get rid of the headache or whatever, but if you overuse pain medication, that can also be a trigger?
Absolutely. Pain medicines can be a real mixed blessing. If you're using pain medicines, and pain medicines, we're talking Advil, we're talking Tylenol, over-the-counter stuff.
Okay.
If you're using those more than 3 days a week, there's a possibility that those headaches will those medications will actually cause the headaches to rebound. And so you'll need to take more medication in order to treat the headache. And in worst case scenarios, over time continuing to do that, you end up with a headache that occurs virtually every single day.
Golly, that's awful. What about food?
Foods are another real serious trigger. Alcohol, obviously, being one of them. Red wine in particular because of the tyramine. But smoked foods, such as smoked fish, can be triggers for it. Anything that's pickled can be a trigger for it. Things sweetened with aspartame may be triggers for migraines. So you want to make sure with your diet that you're eating on a regular basis. You don't skip meals. Lowering blood sugar can be a trigger for migraine.
Okay. So if we're just sort of cognizant of these types of things,
absolutely,
we can maybe lessen the frequency of the migraine, get rid of them altogether.
Well, you probably can't get rid of them altogether just taking those steps, but certainly you can way decrease the frequency of them. You know, utilizing as a supplement, magnesium, about 300 milligrams a day, may actually cut down the frequency of the migraines. So that's an easy thing to do, and you can do that from over-the-counter stuff. So also using something like riboflavin, which is a B2 vitamin, has been shown to help reduce the occurrence of migraines. Coenzyme Q10, also an over-the-counter supplement that's available, at about 100 milligrams a day, can also be effective in helping reduce the frequency of migraines and actually may eliminate the occurrence of them.
That'd be great. Dr. Kaplan, thanks a lot. Appreciate you coming in. Great tips.
Thank
Ali,
you
back
much.
To you.